Hey, I'm Susan. I just want to make this video quickly to give some more dimension to the idea of making a zine in Word. So I'm going to share my screen and go to that Word file that I uploaded. So this isn't really a finished zine. You know, I would never have the page numbers like in my zine, for example. I would remove those at the very end of the process. But I want to definitely keep them so that you can see how unusual the page numbers are when you're making a zine in Word. And you start with page 8 basically on the left column, and then page 1 is on the right column. Then you've got page 2, page 7, page 6, page 3, and pages 4 and 5. So definitely not what you would think off the top of your head about the page numbers. I definitely had to figure it out, even though I'd learned it before, I'd forgotten. So I had to do a little bit of research and just trial and error. This is what it looks like when you print it out. There are 4 pages here, and it's important to know that what you're going for really are 2 double-sided pages. So here is, this is the cover, right? This is the cover of my zine. And this is the back cover of my zine. So you can see those are from the very first page in my Word file. The second page has pages 2 and 7, which are here. So I need to combine these 2 pages into one double-sided page. So I just do that. And I need to either glue or tape this together loosely, so, just so that it stays. So think of this as one piece of paper, a double-sided piece of paper. And then the same thing is true for pages 6 and 3 and pages 4 and 5. And pages 4 and 5 are really the center of the zine. But again, these 2 pieces need to be combined into one, ideally. And now I take these two double-sided pieces and I just put them together so that 4 and 5 are in the middle. And then when I close it, magically it works. I've got my zine. If you go to Office Max or Staples, something like that, they might have what's called a long arm stapler so that you could put like one staple in the middle. Some people don't even staple this type zine. It pretty much stays together. And the great thing about making a zine in Word is you can just literally desktop publish your zine. You could print out 40 copies of that and be done. You wouldn't even have to go anywhere else to use a photocopy machine. But it's that pagination that's so weird. And I want to show you in my other Word file. Here we go. I hope you can see that. I also uploaded this actual template. You could just use this, just download it and use it, put in your writing, copy and paste your images and all of that. And then at the very end, you just want to go in there, you know, and remove all the page numbers, just at the very end, but not until the very end, because you just want to make sure you're totally finished. Go back to the other one for a minute. So this definitely is not finished because I haven't removed the page number. So, you know, I would remove that from zine. That was really just for your benefit to get a handle on what you're looking at. And then I would go through and remove. But notice how each time I do something, things get a little out of whack. So just have to keep moving the columns around whenever they get out of order like that. This is normal. You'll see your columns shift when you're working. That's why I say wait till the end to remove those page numbers, because they're important notifications of, you know, where you are in the zine at any particular moment. So I'm removing these. And maybe move this up a little bit then. See, every move I make shifts my columns a little bit. So let me hit return and get page three back up the top. And then actually remove it. Same thing here. I'm going to move, hit return and get page four back here so that I can remove it. And I don't even need to move page five because I'm going to remove it anyway. So just delete. So now I have my zine finished without any of that crazy page numbering and other comments. So hopefully this makes sense to you guys. I wanted to just keep it pretty quick. Let me know if you have any questions or if you want my help. We can always schedule a zine. We can always schedule a Zoom about zines. And that's it. I forgot to turn on my light on my camera. Hopefully you could, I wasn't in the total dark. Okay, everybody, take care. Enjoy your zine reading and researching and making. And get in touch if you'd like some help, okay? All right, bye.